It's a stretch of road many call home.
It's really sad, you know, that this has to happen.
The block on Technology Drive in northeast Minneapolis, where people without shelter have taken refuge.
Every single one of these people that are here, their circumstances are all different.
Craig Hawkins understands. He used to experience homelessness. Now he brings food to those living in the area that's now the center of a federal lawsuit. Nearby businesses alleging the encampment threatens the well-being of their employees and their finances. They say the city and county are allowing it to thrive, and they've had enough.
Looking at both sides of the fence, you really can't blame them.
Monday, Triangle Warehouse and the property owner they rent from filed a civil suit against Minneapolis and Hennepin County, asking for $50,000 in damages. They say they've lost money because people who live there have stolen their electricity and dumped trash into their pay-by-weight dumpsters. They also allege residents make it unsafe, harassing their employees, blocking exits, and burning garbage. They blame the city for providing accommodations like porta potties and wash stations. Craig knows there's not an easy fix.
At the same time, you know, as a business owner, I mean, with a problem, you really kind of have to be a community member.
And while the businesses ask for the city and county to pay up, Craig also hopes they step up.
It's kind of a responsibility of the city.
So these neighbors aren't left without options.
Well, you're supposed to lift a brother up, not push him back down. And these people ain't got much farther to go down.
Eva Anderson, CARE 11 News.
The city and county have not yet filed a response to the lawsuit, and the city wouldn't comment today. Hennepin County officials shared a statement saying, in part, "We are perplexed as to why Hennepin County is named in this lawsuit. In fact, we have put tremendous resources into helping those experiencing homelessness. Our entire philosophy and approach is based on getting people into shelter and housing."